Well, Detroit has always had a love affair with Neil Diamond. Sellout concerts every time he's in town. This man has lots of power. So does Shirley Eater. And that's how she got this exclusive interview. Shirley decided it was time for Neil to take a break from his sound check.
The fellow who performed here last night, he's performing tonight, and he's performing Wednesday, and he's performing Thursday, and his name is Neil Diamond, and I'm just thrilled that I'm sitting here with a guy who's so friendly with Princess Di and Prince Charlie and wife of the President of the United States. And how are you, Neil?
I'm great. It's great to be here. I didn't expect this kind of weather, though.
Well, we had snow, but, you know.
I know that. But it went past. But it's great to be here Christmas
Neil,
time.
Neil, what is that sound? Do you carry it with you? I hear it.
I don't know. Feedback. We try to get rid of it before the show so we don't have any of it at all
show
starts.
They heard.
Now it's gone forever.
How does your family treat you now that you have, you know, Princess Di and at the White House and dancing?
How do they treat me?
Yeah.
They treat me exactly the same as they always treated me.
Good?
The best. No, it was fun. You know, we went to the White House. It was a tremendous honor to be there. And it was fun. I got to sing a few songs. I was scared to death. And actually danced with Lady Di. And
she asked you to dance.
She asked me to dance. I didn't have the nerve to ask her. You know, everybody else was asking her. And she came over and she asked me. I thought, oh, my gosh, it was great.
How did she say?
She said, I don't know if it's proper to ask a gentleman to dance in this country. And I said, it's always proper for you to ask whoever you want to dance. And we danced, and I was a nervous wreck, and my knees were shaking. And I sat down, as a matter of fact, at a table with Suzanne Farrell, a very spectacular ballerina who just danced with Prince Charles. And she said, my knees are shaking. I said, no, so are mine. So we got through it.
Did you dance cheek to cheek?
No, we didn't dance cheek to cheek. We had a nice conversation about her travels, but it was not that kind of a dance. It was a friendly. We're just friends.
Yeah, I know. And besides, you know, her husband's there, and Marcia, your wife, is there.
Yeah,
and,
this is true.
And, you know, it's hard.
It's very true.
And then when she finished, did you dance with when she finished with you, Neil?
Yes.
Did you dance then with the wife, with Mrs. Reagan?
No, I didn't. I danced with my own wife, or else I would have been in major trouble.
Can you imagine all night dancing with all those people and
No, I was a nervous wreck. I sat down after that. Yeah.
Did you know you were going to sing before?
I didn't know at all, but evidently Mrs. Reagan had mentioned something to the orchestra conductor, and he had prepared a whole list of songs of mine. So when she brought me over to the bandstand, I said, what songs of mine do you know? And he said, well, which ones would you like to do? And he showed me a whole list with my name over it and a whole list of songs. So I picked out a couple, and they did it beautifully.
And I know that you said, I had someone, we went to the same high school, and I sang this duet with her, and I'm going to try and do it alone.
That's right. I'll try and sing both parts tonight. And I asked everyone to dance, and they did. It was kind of a Fellini-esque situation, you know, because I still think that I'm a kid from Brooklyn, and I'm here at the White House, and the prince and the princess and some of the greatest people in, you know, American society were there, and I felt very honored to be there.
You just said you felt like a kid from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
In your wildest dreams in Brooklyn, did you ever think, you probably wanted to be with ball players then, but did you ever think you'd be with the future king of England?
No, of course not. You don't think about things like that. I mean, this is just a little bonus that comes along with a job, which I'm very thankful for. It was fun.
Now, you are also going to be a godfather, along with a lot of other godparents, to Burt Bacharach and Carol Bayer-Sager.
That's right. Burt and Carol adopted a baby last week, and they're happy as clams, and I'm happy for them, too.
Have you been asked to be a godfather, or is that a figure of speech?
Yeah. I think Carol asked a few of her closest friends if they'd be the baby's godfather and godmother.
That's you and Elizabeth Taylor.
And Miss Taylor and...
You still call her Miss Taylor?
Well, she's kind of legendary, you know. You call her Elizabeth when you're with her. I've I've had the chance to have dinner with her a few times, and she's a very funny lady. She's a great lady. And, but no, you don't, in public I call her Miss Taylor, and privately I call her Elizabeth, and,
Does she call you in public, Mr. Diamond? I hope so.
I don't know, but, she's very nice.
Have you danced with her?
No, I haven't.
But that song, I Met a Man, He Danced with His Wife, what was that, Chicago?
Yeah, that's right.
Soon, yes. Is this the end of your Christmas tour?
Well, this is kind of nearing the end of the Christmas tour, which, as I mentioned to you before, we've done. This is our 7th year in a row. And we do it for luck and for fun, and it's great. We just started it when everybody told us we couldn't tour during Christmas. We decided, hey, you know, we're going to tour during Christmas, and the audiences have been the greatest. So we've had a lot of fun.
I've given tickets as Christmas presents, so I think I
get
them. Oh, people are thrilled.
That's great.
I sure have. And
well,
you love Detroit, don't you?
I love Detroit. Detroit is one of those places that feels like home for us, and we do new material here, and we've tried things over the years, and the audiences are just the best. So that's why we're here at this horrible time of year.
Listen, when you're up on the stage tonight, Neil, and somebody gets up in this very quiet audience, you know they're going to be screaming, and you hear somebody say, is it all right for an old broad reporter to ask you to dance? You think I could get to dance with you?
You can, but not during the show.
Right after I'm coming. You know you don't work hard out there. We'll dance backstage.
Great. Anytime.
You are a very good friend, Neil Diamond.
Thanks very much, Shirley. You too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And what can I say? I think I better turn to this camera because they want me to. And this is Shirley Eda saying, what a Superman. I don't mean Superman like with flying Superman. He is a superhuman being. He's a fantastic performer. He's got a new album. He's finished. We'll have to say any more about Neil Diamond. Good afternoon for Good Afternoon Detroit.
She didn't give us tickets for Neil Diamond for Christmas.
She doesn't like you, Marilyn. She gave me two that bring what's your name.
Concert this week is an inside look at what happened at the Neil Diamond concert this weekend.
Hey, we're headed for the future. Give us some room.
You were out concerting last night, huh?
I was at the Neil Diamond, the long-awaited Neil Diamond. He is... Well, it was at his second show last night at the St. Paul Civic Center. Mm-hmm. He had two sold-out shows.
Yeah.
His concert sell out here in the Twin Cities almost instantly.
Yes.
He is quite a star across the country, but it seems especially so here in the Twin Cities, and it was a phenomenal show, and we were there.
He's so popular, and yet you never see him interviewed. I think the Barbara Walters interview with him was the only one I've ever seen.
I think it was probably the only one maybe in 15 years, or I may be exaggerating a little bit.
So I imagine you tried.
Well,
an interview with him.
We did want to get an interview with him and kind of give you highlights of the concert. And we were able to do some of that. Let's take a look right now at what happened to us and at the concert last night and give you a little taste of Neil Diamond as well.
Right now, you're looking at just some of the big crowd as they make their way into the St. Paul Civic Center, because tonight it is the long-awaited Neil Diamond concert.
Now, both of the shows this weekend have been sold out for some time. In fact, Neil Diamond never has trouble filling the seats whenever he comes to the Twin Cities.
Well, yes, it's a big crowd because it's a big event. Neil Diamond is such a mega star that, well, we would have liked to have had an interview with Neil to kind of include in this story, but Neil Diamond does no interviews whatsoever. So we can't do that, but we can talk to, well, some of the folks here, some of his fans, find out what they think about Neil. And I wonder what the attraction is, quite frankly. I wonder if they like his autobiographical music.
I like his autobiographical music.
Or I wonder if they like his soft music, his ballads, or his style.
I like the soft music. I like the ballads. I like his style.
Or I wonder if they like him because, well, he just sings everything. I mean, he sings rock. He sings the classics. He sings everything right down the middle of the fence.
He sings rock, he sings classic, he sings just right down the middle of the road. There's nobody better on the fence than he is.
Well, his fans like him for a lot of reasons, and all of the fans have disappeared from the room because the concert is about to begin inside the arena. Now, I'm sorry we couldn't get the interview, but he just doesn't do them. And we might also show you videos from time to time of performers like Neil Diamond. We have a Neil Diamond video, but he doesn't like it, so he doesn't allow us to use it as well. But the concert's about to begin. We can show you some of the concert. Oh, one thing about that, too. Neil Diamond only allows us to show you 60 seconds. It's beginning right now. Let's go watch 60 seconds of Neil Diamond in concert.
And here he is, Neil Diamond, at the Civic Center in St. Paul, complete with lasers, smoke, and all kinds of special effects. He's doing a new song called Heading for the Future.
Yeah, we're gonna build a new house. We are. It's gotta last a long time. Lean on me. Who's gonna lean on you? We can make it happen. You lean on me. I'm gonna lean on you. We're heading for the future and the future now. Yes, it is. We're gonna do it together.
There you have it, 60 seconds of Neil Diamond in concert. We had to take the cameras out of the arena right now. No interview, no video, rock video, and only 60 seconds of the concert. What we can do, though, is we can show you that 60 seconds again, sort of an instant replay of Neil Diamond in concert with commentary.
So here he is again, the one and only Neil Diamond in instant replay. Now you may notice Neil's let his hair grow a little bit, and look, he's holding his microphone in his right hand tonight. That's classic Neil Diamond. Although in his solitary man period, he sometimes went with the left, but not tonight. Oh, and yes, of course, he's not playing his guitar, but at least not yet. No, the night is young, and anything could happen.
Yeah, we're gonna build a new house. We're gonna make it stand tall. It's gotta last a long time.
So there you have it. Just a taste of Neil Diamond in concert here at the St. Paul Civic Center. And the people that did attend, I guarantee you they saw a great show. 2.5 hours without intermission. Now, no wonder he's so popular here in the Twin City. Now, right here are some of the security police that have been kind of maintaining order here. Was this what kind of crowd was this in terms of other concert crowd?
Good mix of people this year.
Pretty quiet?
They were real quiet compared to other groups.
Well, I tell you what, let me ask you this. Would you like to see Neil Diamond, maybe just a little more Neil Diamond?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see Neil Diamond one more time.
Rowdiest person there.
Yeah,
huh?
I was the most out of control. And I should point out, too, that I really am a big Neil Diamond fan, and I don't really blame him. He's a very private fellow, and those were the rules going in, that we could only do certain things, and so we just had to have a little bit of fun. No cards and letters, please. I'm a Neil Diamond fan, and I have a lot of his albums, and I love his music, so we just had a little fun.
Oh, that was a fun piece. What do you think he would have said to you if he had talked to you?
What would he have said? Oh, gosh, Sharon. I think he might have... I don't know what he would have said, because nobody knows.
He would have said, gee, Gary, I really love your stories on Good Company. You do great work.
You think he'd have said that?